So thank you for being here. This is one of my closest friends, Jennifer Bailey. We've been partners in crime for years and years and years. And she teaches elementary school in Farmington, Michigan. Here, we had a good chat about that with our Farmington alums who are here among us. And she's here to share some things with us today, some things that she does particularly well. Some of you have stepped into her class as part of my class. She's been really generous about that this year at GMM. We didn't do that because they knew we were bringing her in, which is great. And so she does this awesome ukulele curriculum, and she does fantastic technology things with her students. But also she can talk a little bit about the entrepreneurship of being a master teacher, that she sells her materials and her plans to a whole bunch of teachers on the site that you will serve and will soon come to know and love called Teachers Pay Teachers. And so you're paying her to share her stuff with you today as a group, but she does all this great stuff and teachers all over the world buy her materials to use in their classroom as well. It's just they don't get to be up close and personal with her like you do. So she's fantastic with her kids, such a good musician, and a person who writes plans and technology and composes. And so we're going to serenade her with one of my favorite compositions of hers. So you need to be up and moving. First with low, here we go. Bum bada 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 bada. Bum bada 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 bada. Bum bada bum 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 bada. Bum bada 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 bada.
Flick through levels.
Bum bada bada. But you're welcome to come up and grab one if you need one and play along with us. I really want you to do everything that I talk about today because I know from my own personal style of learning and from working with teachers and with kids for 20 plus years that we learn through doing. And I will tell you, I love to listen and take everything in, but if I do it, I'm gonna remember how to teach it to my kids. If I listen to it, I'm gonna recall that it was a really great activity, but I'm gonna forget details about what I did and how I did it. So I really ask you to engage in that way and do as much as you can. We're gonna go super slow today, and I apologize for that, but the reality is I'm gonna teach you like I work with my children. And my children are gonna learn three chords on day one at all. We're gonna get it by the end of this morning. You are gonna be able to play, like we're gonna feed our musicians and play some fun stuff, but we're gonna work in the way that we would be working with young children. And that's building one chord at a time, building their capacity, their strength, because if you've worked with second, third, and fourth graders, they whine a lot,
I got to help them to get over that by saying shush. No, you don't really say that. just in your teacher mind. And it's usually a different word. So we're going to go kind of slow and build on that today. And the reality is, I never put anything in an instrument that does not happen in the body first. And that means if we're playing xylophones, if we're drumming, if we're doing ukuleles, nothing in my classroom happens on an instrument before it happens in the body. And when I say in the body, I mean singing, chanting, moving. So we're going to spend the first part of this morning learning some repertoire so that when we come back at it and we're going to start doing some stuff on ukulele, that it's all familiar to you. I think it's really important that we always scaffold learning with kids. Don't give them a bunch of unfamiliar. Here's an unfamiliar instrument, an unfamiliar chord, and an unfamiliar song, but you should totally rock this out, right? Ew, that's not how it happens. So if I want my kids to be successful, I have to scaffold that learning. The song's got to be familiar, the tonality's got to be familiar, the patterns have to be familiar, the unfamiliar thing is the instrument. And we're gonna just focus on one skill at a time, okay? So I'm gonna give you a choice. You can stay where you are, or you can come up and play for a minute. I'll let you know when I need you. You always have a choice, but please don't stay in your seat the entire morning. Your body needs to move. That's how you learn. And I just told Dr. Marshall the one thing I forgot was my clicker. So I'm gonna be walking back and forth a lot. So creating an optimal environment for your kids. If you want your kids to be successful and love playing ukulele, well, you gotta do a lot of front work at the beginning. They gotta know tunes. They have to know tunes. And if you've ever heard Dr. Bruno come in and do work with the instrumental people, they'll say, man, it's all about tunes. You gotta know tunes, you gotta know tunes. Same is true with your elementary kids. And I'm not saying that they have to know at 10. They should know like 50, 60, 70, 80, 100 tunes that they should be able to play. So lots and lots of folk tunes. They have to know patterns. Rhythm patterns, because that's what they're gonna use as their strumming patterns. So they have to know patterns in a great way, and they have to know it at the hour oral stage, meaning they just go ba 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 ba, and they have to be able to chant them with twos, do, 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 and then they have to be able to read it so that they can put it on that ukulele. Patterns are essential, and you need to be doing those things. Those are like the vegetables. They may not love it, but they need it. It's the nutrients. Tonal patterns too, and tonal patterns, it's not necessarily that they can say do, mi, do, but do they know that do, mi, do is major tonic? Have you ever learned stuff like that before? I went through college and no one ever told me major tonic, and they certainly didn't explain it. Now, my theory person expected me to just know that kind of stuff, but we're gonna walk through how do you teach kids to hear function and label function. Because if they hear one and they hear five, boy, there's nothing they can't play on a ukulele. And if they hear one and four and five, they got pretty much all of Western music. put in a minor or two, no. they really need patterns, and then that pattern work will guide you into harmony work as well. So we're gonna spend the beginning of this workshop singing, chanting, moving, and playing some games. And my hope is that, how many of you are student teaching currently or going to be student teaching in a year? That some of this stuff will build into your library, your repertoire, so that you have something to do when you walk into that first student teaching placement and your co-op says, hey, what you want to teach on Monday? That's really not how it happens. they really say, you're going to observe for a week? No. But when you are prepared to teach, you've got a couple songs in your pocket that you can start with. I know you have more than it. All right, so our very first tune this morning is a little song called John the Rabbit. And I pride myself in being the prop queen of Southeast Michigan. I have a puppet for every occasion. Dr. Marshall can pretty much attest to that. And what I'm very proud is I only brought one. I lied. I didn't see someone did sleep in my bed last night. I have an almost six-year-old, and I said to Dr. Marshall last night, I'm so excited that no one's crawling into bed with me tonight. I get to sleep alone. All right, so listen, please. Just audio. Oh, John the Rabbit, yes, ma'am, had a mighty habit. Yes, ma'am, jumping in my garden. Yes, ma'am, tearing up my cabbage. Yes, ma'am, my fresh tomatoes. Yes, ma'am, my sweet potatoes. Yes, ma'am, and if I live, yes, ma'am, to see next fall. Yes, ma'am, I ain't gonna have. Yes, ma'am, no crying at all. Yes, ma'am. What did you hear John say? Everybody say it together. Sing it together. Ready?
Yes, ma'am.
Beautiful. Every time you see John this time, would you put that yes, ma'am, in your audiation? Oh, John Rabbit.
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, put that in your audiation. Right here. Do you all know what audiation means?
No.
You're going to think it. Oh, John the Rabbit had a mighty habit, jumping in my garden, tearing up my cabbage, my fresh tomatoes, my sweet potatoes. And if I live to see next fall, I ain't gonna have no granada. How many of you were thinking, yes, ma'am, every time? Awesome. Would you do it this time with your mouth?
Yes, ma'am.
What were you audiating? Every time you sing, yes, ma'am, do you know what we call that? When you sing that one pitch like, do, do, do you know what that's called in music? We call that the resting tone. We all say resting tone.
Resting tone.
Okay, now I'm gonna teach you something that is gonna make your principal love you in 5 years. It's called turn and talk. It's one of the only things that principals get when they walk into a music room when they don't know music. So turn to your neighbor and tell your neighbor, we just sang the resting tone.
We just sang the resting tone.
Call your other neighbor, the resting tone is do.
The resting tone is do.
You are all now highly effective. I'm not kidding. It's really that bad. Okay, so, for 8 years, my principal gave me the same feedback. Have you ever thought about doing turn and talk? Oh, no. I just taught my kids how to play Beethoven 9, but sure, I haven't. No. Sure, I'll use turn and talk. The one year I used it, she was like, I love that you use it. I love that you noticed I use it this year. Why do I have them identify resting tone? What's the purpose of that? Do, do. That is the most important piece of information I can get about that song. Why would I teach them that the resting tone is do? What does that tell us about the music? Anything with the resting tone do is in what tonality? Major, right. That's a really simple way of explaining major to little ones. I don't need to tell them about the scale degrees and which is a half step and which is a whole step. If they can audiate do as the resting tone, they got it. They know that that's major. Now, if I really want to mess with my kids, I can sing it a little bit differently. Usually I use a different pepper for this one, but listen. Oh, John the Rabbit, yes, man, had a mighty habit. Yes, man, jumping in my garden. Yes, ma'am, tearing up my cabbage.
Yes, ma'am,
my fresh tomatoes.
Yes, ma'am,
my sweet potatoes.
Yes, ma'am,
and if I live,
yes, ma'am,
to see next fall.
Yes, ma'am,
I can have.
Yes, ma'am,
no garden at all.
Yes, ma'am.
Do you know what I just did to that song? What did I do? I made it minor. So instead of singing do, you sing la. And then if I really want to mess with my kids, would you do this? If I sing a phrase in major, you say, do, do. If I sing a phrase in minor, would you sing, la, la? You know what to do? Oh, John the Rabbit, had a mighty habit. Jumping in my garden, tearing up my cabbage. My fresh tomatoes, my sweet potatoes. And if I live,
do.
This is what my kids. hear phrases, and if they know that do is resting tone for major and la is resting tone for minor, I don't have to explain very much. They use their audiation, they hear, and they start to identify songs as such. That's so important because every song we're going to play in ukulele has a tonality, and we want them to start to hear those things and connect. I'm not in the business of creating imitators. I'm in the business of creating kids who critically think about music. And I was someone who did not learn to audiate until I was in college. And sadly enough, my senior year of college. And so it is so important to me that the two things my kids cannot leave my classroom without learning to do, sing and audiate. Because if they can do those two things, there's nothing that can stop them. And it's amazing what a little bit of audiation will do for a kid. All right, we're coming back to these songs. That's why I'm playing with them with you right now. Listen, please. We are dancing in the forest while the wolf is far away. Who knows what will happen to us if he finds us out of play? Wolf, are you there? Would you be my echo, please? We are dancing in the forest.
We are dancing in the forest.
So you can say, yes, I'm coming to get you, or no, I'm doing something.
Here we go.
We are dancing in the forest while the wolf is far away. Who knows what will happen to us if he finds us at our play?
Wolf, are you there?
Yes, I'm coming to get you.
Another song we've been doing a lot in Michigan because it's rained all week.
Rain, rain, go away. Come again another day. All the children want to play. Rain, rain, go away.
I'm showing great restraint. I have a very difficult time singing a song without a resting tone. I really want to change that tune. But for the purposes of what I'm going to do here, I'm going to keep that sign in so mi la so because I'm going to need to use that when I get to the ukulele. So here's what I'd like you to do. Would you just audio that sign one more time?
Rain, rain, go away. Come again another day. All the children want to play. Rain, rain, go away.
I think you can sing that sign with me. Here we go.
Rain, rain, go away, come again another day. All the children want to play. Rain, rain, go away.
Beautiful, would you be my echo? Do, mi, do.
Do, mi, do.
So, mi, do.
So, mi, do.
Ti, re, fa.
Ti, re,
fa. Ti, re, fa. Do, so, mi.
La, fa.
La, fa.
So, mi, do.
So, mi, do.
Ti, re, so.
Ti, re, so.
So, mi, do.
So, mi, do.
Beautiful. Very beautiful thing. Why do you think I had you watch and wait in those patterns? What was the purpose of that?
So we could undo it?
Yeah. If I gave you a pattern and gave you a gesture and gave you a pattern and gave you a gesture and gave you a pattern and gave you a gesture and gave you a pattern and gave you a gesture, what starts to happen? You're just imitating. Anybody can imitate. I can go and listen to an Italian tape and listen to the same sentence 20 times and then repeat that sentence, but not have a clue what I was just saying, right? We do that with kids all the time. We sing patterns, we let them imitate the pattern, and we go, oh, our kids are awesome. Yeah, but what did they learn? Audiate, let them keep that in their brain. Now, it's not just enough to give them that pattern. Now we gotta do something with that pattern. So I'm gonna ask everyone to stand up. Push your seat in, just stand up behind your seat. We play a game in my room called Walk the Plank. I don't know why we call it Walk the Plank, it probably morphed into that. But it's really just a game to get us going with function. Do you know what I say when I mean function? Or what I mean when I say function? So we know in my music room that anytime my kids hear a pattern that has the sounds do, mi, or so, and nothing else, that we call that major tonic. That's a tonic function. Would you all say major tonic?
Major tonic.
Now turn to your neighbor and tell them do, mi, and so is major tonic.
Do, mi, and so is major tonic.
Now turn to your other neighbor and say, what is major tonic?
What is major tonic?
And answer them.
Thank
you. No good to ask the question if you don't get the answer. Okay, now if I sing any other sounds besides do, mi, or so, you are not going to say anything. You might think an answer, but you don't get to say an answer. So when I sing do, mi, and so, your job is to very gently take a jump and say, major tonic, let's try it. Do, mi, so.
Major tonic.
Excellent. If I sing any other pattern like T, Fre, Fa, don't jump, don't flinch, don't breathe, I will see you and call you out. You will be done. You will walk the plank. I know it sounds vicious and it is the first two times that we do it. And then they start to get this. All right, here we go. Do, mi, so.
Major tonic.
So, mi, do.
Major tonic.
So, mi, so. You're all out. That was major tonic. Now, why did I do that? I know you all went, oh, I don't know my sister. It can have do, mi, or so. It doesn't have to have all three sounds. It has to have at least two of them. Do, or mi, or so, and nothing else. Okay? So you would have all been out. You would have all walked the plank, and then I would have been the winner. Here's the thing. And like I said, it only happens the first two times, and then you really get savvy to my ways. Are you ready? Let's try again. Do, so, mi,
major tonic.
So, mi, do,
major tonic.
Ti, re, fa. Ooh, you didn't even flinch except for you. No, I'm just kidding. Ti, re, ti. So, do,
major tonic.
Sometimes I will not jump just to make sure they're not imitating my jump and really not knowing the answer. So now I gotta sit a little sneaky with them. Do, so, mi,
major tonic.
So, mi, do,
major tonic.
Ti, re, fa, fa, re, re, ti, ti, so, la, fa, do, do, so, do,
major tonic.
So, mi, do,
major tonic.
Do, ti, do, do, re, ooh, that was bad. Do, re, do, do, mi,
major tonic.
Okay, you get the idea. So once they get really good at that, then we flip it. Boys and girls, you know all those patterns I sang that had so, fa, re, or ti. That's really called major dominant. Can you turn to your neighbor and say, major dominant?
Major dominant.
Somebody's gonna say major dominant, and that's not it. And Dominic in the classroom is gonna get mad that we're saying his name. So make sure they know that it's dominant with the T. And then turn to your other neighbor and say, so, fa, re, or ti, make major dominant.
So far,
all right, and now we play the game, and this time you can only jump on a major dominant, not a major tonic, which messes with them more. We'll just do a few. Here we go. Do, mi, do. I knew you would jump. Do, mi, so, fa, re.
Major dominant.
Ti, re, ti.
Major dominant.
Ti, re, fa.
Major dominant.
Ti, re, so.
Major dominant.
So, mi, do. Great, have a seat. So why do we play a game like that in my room? What are we getting out of it? checking for understanding. Why do I play that game with the kids?
So you can test if they can hear function or not?
So they can hear function and identify function. I know they can hear it. I want to know, are they identifying it, or are they understanding what comprises conifer dominant?
They're also auditing it while you're
seeing. Yeah, how many patterns did I see in between, maybe a tonic pattern or a dominant pattern that you just got to listen? And you are on the edge of your toes listening because you're not on your seat. Like, you are really like, oh, is she going to do it this time? That is like the highest level engagement, because you are really listening to see whether or not I'm going to sing that pattern that you need to jump to. So my kids are getting washed in all of this great pattern work. They're getting to hear patterns. They're getting to hear tuneful singing. They're getting to hear function and identify function. And kids that can hear that are unstoppable. When I came to the school that I'm teaching at now, I'm going into my 10th year, I had this one little boy who was just loved music. Like, music dripped out of this kid. But they had a teacher in the building that was really... They fired him. And Michigan doesn't fire anybody. So he was so bad, they fired this teacher. And this kid comes into my classroom in first grade, and by second grade, like, we're doing all this fun stuff with them, and by second grade, we're naming tonic and dominant. And I say, fa, fa, fa. And he was like, what's that? And I'm like, that's called subdominant, but we're not ready for that yet. This little kid played piano. And it would start, he like writing his own tunes, and then his uncle was a guitar player, so uncle and he at Christmas sat down and showed him a couple chords. This kid, by the time he was done in fourth grade, was doing an independent study with me and my student teacher, because he was writing music that was so much more advanced than my kids. I have video, I'll show you maybe at a break, of this kid's doing stuff with those. I mean, he just needed this tiny, tiny bit of information, and his brain exploded. The very first time, we used to do a collage concert, and the very first time the kids came in and they all have to like show what they're gonna do at the collage concert. So here are all these little third graders, are like, I'm gonna play Hot Cross Buns on the piano. Mi, re, do. And then this little boy comes in, he's like, I'm gonna play a song from, my brain is not on today. La Vida, Coldplay. He played a Coldplay song. And then like shamed everybody in the room, because not only did he play it on his guitar, but he performed it like, and we're all just like, what just happened here? It was that kid that needed this much information, like just needed a tonic and dominant, subdominant chord, and suddenly he could hear it, he needed names for it. He didn't know what the names were, and he just needed that little bit of information. Those are really simple games. What you just did is what we do in second grade. We play with tonic, we play with dominant, we play with function, and then we put it into songs all the time. If you guys have questions, I talk a lot, so ask, please. So let's do a little bit of this. You all know row, row, row your boat, right? Okay, let's sing it once just to establish tonality. So la, so fa, mi, re, ti, do, wow, I'm really low today. So la, so fa, mi, re, ti, do. I'm gonna go a little higher. Row, row, row your boat gently down the stream. Merrily, 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 life is but a dream. You've got it. Yum, bum, bum.
Row, row, row your boat gently down the stream. Merrily, 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 life is but a dream.
But that's okay, once you sing our melody again, and I'm gonna add in the other part. Here we go.
Down, row, row, row your boat gently down the stream. Merrily, 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 life is but a dream.
There we go, that's much better, Miss Bailey. All right, boys and girls, when you see my finger do this, I'm singing do, but I'm really audiating two other sounds. What other two sounds am I audiating? If this is major tonic, I'm probably auditing do and mi and so. Good. And if I'm singing so or so, I'm auditing so, fa, re, and ti. But because my vocal cords don't allow it, I can only sing one of those sounds. So I sing so. Would you sing your song one more time and show me with your fingers what you're audioing? You're really just doing what I'm doing. Here we go.
Row, row, row your boat gently down the stream. Merrily, 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 life is but a dream.
When that happens, then what I might do is have just a group. Everybody from here, your job is just to sing do, 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 do. My middle people, your job is just to sing me, 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 me. And the side, your job is to sing so, so. There's safety in numbers. So if I actually will put them in a big group, or in a circle, so they kind of get this circle of sound that goes there. It's not always perfect. If it crashes and burns, it tells me something about what they know or don't know, right? So if they can't hold do or mi or so, I probably need to go back and do more pattern work. But if they, sometimes just grouping them so that they're not all picking something randomly out of the air will help a lot. Does that make sense? That's a great way to get them to the dominant too. So this group, you're gonna sing do, ti, do. This group you're gonna sing mi, re, mi. This group you're gonna go so, so, so. And then the horn's gonna, that's not fair. And then you can switch them around. But that's a great way to introduce the dominant into them as well, or for them as well. Okay, any other questions? No, you're doing okay? Would you like to get up and move for a minute?
Mm-hmm.
The answer is yes. So, how many of you worked in Dr. Marshall's early childhood program? You've worked with babies. How many of you have done student teaching with kindergartners or first graders, or teach kindergartners or first graders? So you know if you work with little ones, a favorite activity to do is called move and freeze, which kids move when the music's going and freeze when the music stops. And I don't do that activity after first grade because the reality is the kids just, like, they get self-conscious and they feel like, oh, it's a baby activity. But inevitably, they need to move. And if we're not doing a folk dance of some kind, I like to reinvent move and freeze with them. So we do move and freeze with rhythm cards. My kids told me when I did this with my second grader, she's like, this is better than trading pokey cards. And I'm like, oh, that's a hot compliment.
That's hilarious.
and they're allowed in school, which your pokey cards are not. All right, so we're going to do a move and freeze, and here's the deal. Everyone that comes up to play gets a rhythm card. And the music's going to start, and you get to read your pattern. So if I hold up this pattern, I know you can't see in the back, this pattern says, do, do they, do, do. Because again, my kids have had lots of time learning patterns orally and putting in solfege with it. So, and we've transferred to reading. I do reading the end of first grade, going into second grade. It's not a perfect fit with the MLT sequence, but I also have a curriculum and report cards that I'm beholden to, so I do what I do. So I'm gonna look at this pattern. This is my card, I'm gonna go, do, 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 they, do. And I can move anywhere in the room as I'm reading my pattern. Do, 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 they, do. And then I come across Erin, and Erin's got a card, and it's different, so I'm like, what's Jade? And then I get a new card, and I'm like, do, they, do, they, do, they. You can trade cards as many times as you want, but here's the deal. When the music stops, you freeze, and I'm gonna read a pattern, and if that pattern is in your hands, you won move and freeze that day. I'm telling you, when you're a second or third grader, there's no greater thing than when you move and freeze that day. All right, come on up, grab a card. You know you wanna play, come on! You've been sitting a long time, stretch those legs, get some blood going. Come on, come on, come on! Can I make you, and listen, the orange and the turquoise, these are all like level one, that's all quarter note, eighth note. These have quarter rest. So if you'd like to challenge yourself with a quarter rest, Tinker got burned with a clinker and he began to cry, Mom, Mom, what a poor fellow am I. Little Tom Tinker got burned with a clinker and he began to cry, Mom, Mom, what a poor fellow am I. So here's my first question. What is a clinker? Nate?
I believe, hopefully this is right or it's going to be really
That's important to know because somebody in your class is going to be like, what's a clinker? And you don't want to look, well, you don't want to look like that teacher. Okay, so clinker, well, why did I choose the song? How is this song different than every song we've sung up until the second? Do you know? Would you like to hear it one more time so that more than three hands are up? Little Tom Tinker got burned with a clinker and he began to cry. Mom, Mom, what a poor fellow am I? What are you noticing about that song that's different than every other song we've done so far? Yeah, it's a different meter. And here's the reality. Almost all the folk tunes we do with kids are in duple meter, and they check out after a while. They're like, oh, another duple meter song, great. So please mix it up, and folk songs and nursery rhymes are great places to get triple meter stuff. Sally go round the sun, Sally go round the moon, Sally go round the chimney top every afternoon. Boom. Great little circle to play with your kids. So when I'm doing strumming work, we don't do everything in duple. We do patterns in triple as well, because at some point they're going to need some triple patterns when they have a triple meter song. And we know what something is by knowing what it isn't. We appreciate duple so much more when we've had to do something in triple. We appreciate triple so much more when we've had to do something in 5/8. Right? Never have you loved usual meter until you had to count in 7/8 for other meters. All right. We'll do one more song, just because this is going to get us to the chorus. Listen, please, circle to the left, dull brass wagon, circle to the left, dull brass wagon, circle to the left, dull brass wagon, you're the one, my darling. Sorry that all the words aren't up there, this is where I need a clicker. Circle to the right, oh brass wagon, circle to the right, oh brass wagon, circle to the right, oh brass wagon, you're the one, my darling. Think you got it? Would you sing it with me? Here we go.
Circle to the left, old brass wagon. Circle to the left, old brass wagon. Circle to the left, old brass wagon. You're the one, my darling. Circle to the right, old brass wagon. Circle to the right, old brass wagon. Circle to the right, old brass wagon. You're the one, my darling.
So I'm going to go back here. Can I have a volunteer just come click? Because I don't want to sit here. Thank you. Boys and girls, this song has a new chord in it. Would you listen? Actually, would you sing the song and I'm going to put in the harmony part? Listen. Here we go. Your job is to sing. My job is to do the harmony. Just double check and let me know what to do. Here we go.
Circle to the left, old brass wagon. Circle to the left, old brass wagon. Circle to the left, old brass wagon. You're the one, my darling.
Seven.
Circle to the left, oh rest wagon. Circle to the left, oh rest wagon. Circle to the left, oh rest wagon.
Thank you.
get the instrument. So I just want to show you really quickly what most of you probably have in your hands, and if you